ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर टू ऑफ द चैप्टर मैनेजमेंट एंड बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट। सो वी हैव स्टडीड द फर्स्ट फीचर ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट, दैट इज एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस, एंड सेकेंड फीचर दैट इज स्पेसिफिक और जनरल फोर्सेस, राइट। नाउ वी विल बी मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट फीचर, दैट इज इंटर रिलेटेडनेस। नेक्स्ट फीचर ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट स्टूडेंट इज इंटर रिलेटेडनेस। ओके, सो मोस्ट ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज इन अ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट आर इंटर रिलेटेड। वन फोर्स इज इनडायरेक्टली और डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू अनदर फोर्स। सो मोस्ट ऑफ द बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट, द एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज ऑफ द बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट आर इंटर रिलेटेड। So changes in general forces lead to changes in specific forces. Just take one example, change in technology or greater awareness for healthcare, that will change the consumer tastes and preferences. So when there will be a greater awareness for healthcare, about the health, what consumer will do? They will stop taking the fast foods, okay? So they will consume more fresh fruits and vegetables, all the healthy foods. They will take the balanced diet, isn't it or not? Yes. So what will happen? Due to that, the consumer's taste and preferences will change, and as a result, there will be an impact on the business organization as well. So, for example, increased demand of electronic goods or health products is forcing business organization to bring in changes in their product portfolio to meet the changed market demands. So, more electronic goods, the technology will be applied for, different health products will come in the market, as because it has changed the taste and preferences of the consumer. Number four is dynamic. Yes, most forces in the business environment are dynamic in nature. The dynamics of external forces keep changing due to constant change in technology. Due to constant change in technology that keeps changing. Constant change in technology. Okay. Taste and preferences of consumers are changing, isn't it or not? Availability of newer raw materials are there. So, business, we can say that the business environment is dynamic in nature. Number five, uncertain. Why this is so? The continuous change in the external forces makes the business environment uncertain. When the external forces will change continuously, then that will make the business environment uncertain. In the era of innovation, it is difficult to predict future happenings. As we know, during the innovation period, it is difficult to predict what will happen in the future. For example, every day a new application or a software is developed. We know that the new application or new softwares are developing each and every day. Why? So as to meet the change, meet the demand of the consumer. Number six, complex. Obviously, business environment is complex in nature. So many things are there in business environment. It consists of various interrelated and ever-changing forces. It may be able to understand new forces, but it will extremely be difficult to prepare the strategy how to handle all the external forces together. So difficult to formulate strategy how to manage all the external forces. Isn't it or not? Yes. Now you see, a business may introduce a new kind of soft drink in the market. Okay, it can easily prepare its strategy to handle competitors, consumers, etc. But it may not be able to foresee any social or legal problems related to this production techniques. So now a business is preparing a soft drink to be introduced in the market. So for that, it can compete with the competitors, but it cannot exactly foresee, predict what the social and legal problems may be there related to the production techniques. Okay. Number 7 is relative. What does it mean? It is a relative concept. The business environment is a relative concept. The nature of forces and the impact on business organizations basically differs from the country to country and even from region to region. Just for the example, change in fashion. If there is a change in fashion, that may affect the consumer taste and preference. Affect consumer taste and preference. Where in the European countries, change in fashion may affect the consumer taste and preference in European countries as compared to the Asian countries. Suppose in Asia, India is there. So its culture will not change so much due to change in fashion, but it will affect the European countries the most. Okay, so these are some of the examples and these are the features. Next, we will move towards the importance of business environment. So let's study about the importance of the business environment, right? So why it is important? Why the business environment is important? Importance of business environment. Number 1, it enables the firm to identify opportunities and getting the first mover advantage. So it helps the firm to identify what are the opportunities are there and getting the first mover advantage. Means what? Just take one example, Samsung. You know about the Samsung company? Samsung has identified the popularity, okay? And it has come to understand how much is the scope of the smartphones, how it can grow in the market, okay? And Google, advanced Google has developed the Android, whereas Nokia failed to identify this scope. Nokia failed to identify the scope and they continue to use its Symbian operating system. Nokia used to use the Symbian operating system, and due to this, the Nokia's market share has fallen down from 55%. At first, market share of Nokia was 55%. More than 50% people used to use this Nokia phone. Okay, so as a result, from 55%, it has fallen down to 27.7% in the year of 2014. Why it is so? It has failed to understand that how much is the requirement of the Android at that time. Thus, it has failed to meet with the taste and preferences of the consumer, and as a result, it has lost its market share to a huge proportion. You just come to see that, can see that 55% to 27.7%. So it's a huge move. So thus we can say that this business environment, the positive External strains. Business environment means the external forces that helps the firm to identify that what are the opportunities. That was the opportunity, the development of smartphones, the implementation of the Android. That was very much important. But those who cannot fail the same has not made it. And as a result, what happened? It has really incurred a huge loss. Okay. So thus, this is the number one point. Number two, what is the importance? It helps the firm to identify threats. What are the threats are there in the market? And what are early warning signals? What things to change? So it helps to identify threats in the market and early warning signals in the market, right? Adverse change in the external forces act as threats to the business, which hinders its performance. Okay, so when there will be a huge change in the market forces, it will act as threats to the business. Now is the time to change. Now is the time to implement the new change, the new innovation. Okay, so early identification of threats act as a warning signal and helps manager to prepare the strategies to convert threats into opportunities. This thing is very much important. How you can convert the threats of the market to opportunities. So now, in the above case, you just see in the Nokia case, the threat was that there is a need to implement the Android. People are in need of the smartphone. But if you can convert it into Android, then you can have a great opportunity. Maybe the market share of 55% may reach to 75%. But when you are not identified, you have not identified what are the threats that you need a change and you have not implemented the change, it has come to 27.7%. So what does it mean? That so much distraction can happen if you cannot convert these threats into opportunities, right? Number three, it helps in tapping useful resources. So it helps in tapping useful resources as well. See, just take one example that government announced reduction of custom duty. As you know about the custom duty, you have studied in class 11. So government has announced about the reduction of custom duty, that the custom duty will be reduced. When? If the goods were imported from Korea. If from Korea we will import the goods, then the custom duty amount will be less. So that will attract all the importers, and importers will just import the goods from Korea because that cost will be lesser. So this is one of the useful resources that needs to be tapped at the earliest. Okay. Next point is, it helps in coping with rapid changes. So helps in coping with rapid changes. What does it mean? Just take one example. A model of car. Okay. Or a new model of mobile. All these things, the models are changing over time. With the passage of time, their models, their formation, the innovation technique, each and everything is changing. Why? Because they have to adapt the change with the environment. So now students, in the next lecture, lecture number 3, we will continue with the remaining importance.